A couple of years ago, I was teaching grade 5 here at NIST, and the students were learning about organization and how to be organized. And we had a guest speaker. He was a parent in the school. He was also an author. He just published a children's book. And he came up onto the stage, and he said, if you want to be an author, or actually if you want to be anything, you're going to have to remember your ideas. But ideas are like bubbles. If you don't catch them, they float away. And then he held up a big stack of notebooks, all beaten up and held together with hair bands. He was Sikh. And he said, these are my bubble catches. This is where I keep my ideas. Now, I don't think any of us really remember anything else he said, to be honest, because we were all just still sitting there thinking about the powerful imagery of what he just said, but also the profound truth behind what he just said. We were also thinking, we all need to go and buy some bubble catchers immediately. So, we did. In a couple of days later, we set off with the kids. We went to Central Chitlam to a stationery shop, and we went on the SkyTrain, and some kids for the first time navigated public transport, and it was a whole story of learning in itself. When we got there, they spent quite a long time looking at the notebooks, the bubble catchers, and making choices and talking about the advantages of small ones over big ones and big ones over small ones. Took quite a long time to make the decisions. And then they handed over the cash for their bubble catchers. So they owned the bubble catcher, which of course meant that they took care of it. On the way back, we were on the tuk-tuk, on the school tuk-tuk, and they were pulling them out and explaining why they got this one and explaining their choices. Now, you don't have to take your kids to a stationery shop to do this idea. Last week in my school, I organized a sale of bubble catchers. I have a vision that one day we can be a one-to-one bubble catcher school. And this is a kindergarten girl, and she's already treasuring it. She already owns it and loves it and draws in it and writes in it. And we want kids to draw and write, and we want them to want to draw and write. So what does a bubble catcher do? Well, it's a place for you to reflect and capture your thinking, the way you're feeling at any given time. It's a place for you to dream and design. This is a grade one kid's idea for a mural. That's my daughter's idea for her next birthday cake. Maybe the adults around her can help her take it from bubble catcher to oven. From oven to table, and then the rest, I won't go into. It's a place for you to think visually, make connections in the way that you learn. It's a place to identify priorities, store them, so that you can keep coming back to them. We all know how carried away we get in schools. It's a place for you to capture your questions. It's a place to store useful information. Maybe not the best place for this information, but we're in the business of creating habits, and that's what this does. It's a place to write down processes and instructions. This is my other daughter. She just watched a chef cook an omelet. She wrote down all the instructions. It's a place to do to-do lists, another habit that's so important. And how wonderful to teach kids that great feeling of crossing something off when you've done it. Of course, it's a place to take notes. It's a place to develop your ability to think visually. It's a place to practice your calligraphy, which is still important. And perhaps one of the most profound things is it's a place to capture quotes. Quotes that move students personally from one place to the next in their lives, but also a quote that can move their learning from one place to the next. After a while, you kind of get a portfolio of your thinking and your wonderings and your feelings and your ideas and your questions. You have a constant source of inspiration to go back to. So a bubble catcher, it's not a new idea. I think it's probably a forgotten idea. And I'm really enjoying remembering it. Thank you.